In early June, more than 150 MnDOT maintenance professionals from all over Minnesota gathered in Sandstone to talk about how each district pursues a similar goal, the durable patch.
We're here in Sandstone today at our maintenance facility, and it's basically a durable patching demonstration day. So there's equipment from multiple districts around the state. The purpose is a couple-fold. It's to demonstrate different methods for maintenance repairs, not only patching, but surface treatments, micro-surfacing, and so forth. But B, to bring everybody together and be able to share that knowledge, so you know, we kind of have a wider vision of what's going on in the state.
The durable patch is about using the right tools at the right time in the right situation. We want our crews to be able to patch a road once and have those repairs last a long time. So our road warriors gathered to share ideas and talk about what works for them. They also demonstrated new tools that they have been road testing. Here are some of the new techniques our crews are trying out. In Duluth, crews are using a new milling machine, a grinding wheel that takes off the top layers of a road. This one cuts an 18-inch swath out of the road about 2 inches deep. This gives the crew a clean, rectangular area with straight sides that can then be filled with hot mix. This is especially effective on seams in the pavement. When we build roads, we have seams, also called paving joints, that help with expansion in the summer and contraction in the winter. Those seams are the first to deteriorate, and this milling machine takes out the weak areas on either side of the seam so our crews can install a patch that lasts longer.
What I really learned today is that the pavements, the patching material, the equipment is getting better. It's still very difficult and time-consuming to do this work, so what I think we need to do is really make sure that we're building these projects to last a long time so that we can minimize the maintenance and material work that's going on.
Mastic is a material we are testing for road patching, and it creates a particularly strong bond with the road. It comes in the form of a brick, which we put into a machine that melts it down. Consequently, it can be used in the summer or winter, and it's ideal for smaller potholes and cracks. We have also been trying it with cupped concrete roads in central Minnesota to take some of the bumps out of the ride, and it's been effective. Because of its flexibility and ease of use, Mastic looks like it might be ideal for quick fixes in poor conditions, when it's cold or wet or snowy or icy. Micro-surfacing is another way to preserve old road and extend pavement life. It's similar to seal coating or chip sealing, only on steroids. It blends oil, cement, and rock chips, and then applies a smooth coat of this mixture to a road. The pavement zipper has been used in northwestern Minnesota to help install culverts. Like a milling machine, this tool grinds through a road's surface, but this goes all the way through to the gravel bed. The pavement zipper grinds all the material, which is set aside so crews can replace the culvert. MnDOT then recycles the ground-up road material to rebuild the road. There were more than 15 different tools demonstrated in Sandstone, and our maintenance professionals got a unique opportunity to share their best practices and learn from each other.
I'm Bev Fairher. I'm the Metro District Maintenance Engineer, and I have enjoyed myself enormously today at the demo. I've learned a lot. I've met a lot of people who are passionate and very wise about their jobs, and they've done a beautifully professional job of sharing their knowledge, their wisdom, their expertise, and the lessons they've learned on the road, and it's going to make a difference.
Well, we're just wrapping up our maintenance demonstration day at the Sandstone truck station. The weather was somewhat cold and a little moist, but we had a successful day here, and we demonstrated equipment today from across the state and different technologies. We had a successful turnout. We had maintenance workers and maintenance leaders from across the state, and we met to demonstrate some of the products that we are trying out under the MnDOT Better Patching for Better Roads program. All in all, a great day.